belong here. If my Father is the healer, I don't belong sick. If my Father is the deliverer, I don't belong bound. If my Father is the provider, I don't belong broke. For I've never seen the righteous forsaken, nor his seed begging bread. If my Father is who he is, I can snap out of this. Came to the pit. No angel appeared. No bishop came and said, it's time to get out, bro. No angel said, get it up out of the pit, boys. Nothing. Just like the four lepers at the gate, he just...
Praise God, everybody. This is Tye Tribbett, and you are watching FOSDP, Heavenly Gifted, Uniquely Inspired by Christ, and oh, so fresh. Keep it locked.
Hi, this is Jamie with FOSDP, and I am live at the City of Refuge for the 13th annual Back to School Stop the Violence, Put Christ First event. And I have a special treat for you guys. I have gospel sensation Tye Tribbett, and I can't believe it right now. How are you doing tonight?
I'm great. Thank you. Thank you. It's a pleasure to be here. Thanks for having me.
It's a pleasure to have you here. Okay, first I want to start. Well, I want to talk about your album, Fresh, which I had a chance to listen to it, and I love it.
Okay, thank
you. And, you know, one of the things that I enjoy about the album is you have a snippet in the album where you say you're tired of the same old, same old.
Yeah.
It's time for a brand new start with a brand new heart.
Yeah.
Tell us a little bit about that.
Well, Fresh, tired of the same old is not me looking outwardly, it's me looking inwardly, tired of my same old, the thought patterns, everything. So Fresh is based on the scripture, Isaiah 43:18-19, which says, remember not the former things, neither consider the things of old. God said, behold, I do a new thing. So that's what Fresh is all about, God doing a new thing in me and me crying out for something more from the Lord. So yeah, I think a lot of people are sick of the same cycle within themselves, and only God can stop and give you something fresh.
Right. And I won't last without I need you. How would you describe or define your album?
It's fresh. Okay. No, I'm just it's fresh. It's different. It's it's nothing like I've ever done before. Musically, it stretches, and vocally, and the lyrics, everything to me screams fresh. Screams something, do something different, and I just thank God for it.
Okay, so
I love it.
I don't know it, man. I know how to anoint myself. If nobody celebrate me, I know how. Come on, y'all. You gotta get to the point where you wanna snap. I don't need assistance this time. I'm not gonna stay here. I choose to move. I choose to go forward. He said, I will arise and go forth. With no outside assistance, he snapped. Tell you, neighbor, I'm getting ready to snap it here. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And the thing I love about it is, in my third closing, in my final closing,
what is your favorite song on the album, and what do you love most about this particular song?
All right, I have 16 favorite songs on here, and there's 16 tracks on there. However, when I put the CD on, I always go to track 4. It's called Only Help. You're my only help. I lift my hands to you. You're my only help. And when you all hear it, you'll understand why. That's like very near and dear to my heart. That and When the Rocks Hit the Ground. What was the second part of the question?
What do you love so much about this particular song?
Oh, yeah. It's just very transparent. It's very, just crying out to God. Say, Lord, you're my only help. And you got to hear it to understand why I love it so much. That and When the Rocks Hit the Ground. It's a song about his grace and his love and his mercy.
And tell me a little bit about your experience working with the writers and producers that you work with on your current album.
I didn't really work, quote unquote, work with, you know, how people would think, we in the studio, we get it. No, I just, you know, whoever wrote with me on here, I heard a track that I like, hey, can I have it? Yeah. But I was in the studio by myself most of the time, and it was a different experience not having all the big GA in there, not having a choir anymore. It's a different experience, you know, you know, I miss the choir, you know. Yeah, however, it's a fresh start and it's a new day, so I have to embrace it.
Well, I know so many people are excited about this album. I know I listen to your music every day. Your music keeps me going. It inspires me. One of my favorite songs, I just have to say that, is Look Up.
Oh, yeah.
That's a song that I play, everybody knows, at Viola every day. Look Up. But what I want to ask you is, gospel artists are starting to do so many great things. They're getting into acting. They're having clothing lines. They're intermingling with the secular world. Has there ever been a time for you where you felt like you had to hide the fact that you're a Christian? Or do you always boldly proclaim Christ no matter what situation you're in?
Yeah, I don't know if I boldly proclaim it everywhere, like in secular settings like the mall or the movies. I don't know if I'm Jesus. I don't know if I boldly, but I don't ever feel like there's a time where I'm ashamed of it ever at all. I feel like we carry the most valuable person in the earth, that is the Holy Spirit, and I feel like it should be, you know, publicized. I'm not ashamed at all.
Okay. So tell me, we have a lot of people out there who don't have a walk with Christ, they don't believe in God, or they're straddling the fence. I want you to tell them, do you think it's important for them to have a personal relationship with Christ? How important is that relationship? Building it. You know, getting to know him as their Savior.
Well, I was just thinking about this not too long ago. It's crazy you asked that. And I was saying to myself, man, it's just so good to have God be a part of my life. And I was like, wait, no, he's not a part of my life. He is my life. You know what I mean? It's because of him that I have life. The Bible says, in the beginning, God. If any man be in Christ, he's a new creature. It's all about him. He is our existence now. So those who are not, you know, walking in that relationship with Christ, you're not even living yet. You haven't even begun to start living yet. And once you embrace the relationship, you'll realize, man, I was dead. The Bible says we are dead in the trespasses of our sin until we accept the sacrifice of Jesus Christ, who makes us alive and who quickens us to life. So we're not even living yet. So don't make God a part of your life. He is your life. So come alive.
You know, that's amazing that you say that. Why gospel music? With a voice like yours and with talent like yours, why did you choose gospel music?
I can't do anything else. You know, I ain't gonna name secular artists, but I can't do any of that other stuff. And when it's not a choice to me. It's life to me. You know what I mean? I think most people sing from and about their life, and this is my life. You know, I'm not perfect by a long shot. However, it validates me for the grace and the love and the blood of Jesus. So I don't think I had a choice. You know what I mean? Like, oh, let me do R&B. Nah, I'm going to do gospel. I grew up in church. That's all I know. And, you know, even when I did actually do some R&B and hip hop, it just didn't feel right. It didn't feel like it's where I belong. So I won't be settled anywhere. I'll get a stomach ache. I'll get a headache. Something going to go wrong until I just come back over to where, you know,
this
I need to
be.
This
is my last question. No problem. What I want to know is, you're here at the back to school event.
Yeah.
Why is it so important to give back to people in the community and reach out to those people who don't really get a chance to touch you? I know I follow you on Twitter.
Okay.
And I know somebody said on Twitter that they thank you for just hugging them, embracing them. Yeah. Why is that so important to give back to people who don't know you?
Because I am them. I think when we forget when we forget where we come from, or you were once in school, you had to get your diapers changed too, you fell, you bled. When we forget that, and we just because we've been exposed to greater things than other people have, we feel like that's who we are. No, I'm the person in the audience watching me. I'm the one in the hood. Well, I'm them. I'm no different than anybody else. I have a mic in my hand, I have a voice, and I have a different platform. However, I feel like we're one and the same. And so keeping that type of mentality, it allows you to be more compassionate and embrace everybody like Christ did, you know, so.
Well, it's been amazing. I'm so glad that you took the time to talk to us. FOSDP loves you.
Thank you, FOSDP.
We know that you are blessed and highly favored. You're a kingdom man, and I appreciate that.
Thank you very much.
Want you to give one last word to our audience out there.
Ladies and gentlemen, no matter where you come from, no matter how far you think you've strayed, no matter how bad you think you blew it, I thought I did too. However, you can always start fresh. God is not a God that holds grudges. He's a God that is waiting to love you. So drop everything. Start fresh. October 19th, the CD comes out fresh. October 19th, don't burn it. Buy it.
God bless. I'm already going to buy it, guys.
You're already going to buy it?
Guys, buy it too. I have all the
You can pre-order it right now on Amazon, and you can pre-order
Zoom.
It. So.